All right, so my official introduction. So, hello everybody, and those watching video. Today is Wednesday, March the 29th, 2023. Thank you for being here or for watching online. Today we're very happy to have the Kadima String Quartet with us again. Some of our fan favorites here. They played for us many, many times. They're gonna play some different styles of quartet music for you, almost exclusively by female composers, correct? Except maybe one piece is not, but one piece, or some selections from this. And then we'll have a chance to chat with them a little bit, ask them some questions, and then come back at 2:30 for the concert. You can find the program on the concert website. And so, without further ado, the Kadima String Quartet.
Thank you. So today we're starting now by playing the Haydn String Quartet, The Joke.
That's correct. This piece, which is squarely in the classical period of music. Anybody has heard of the classical period? Classical period? Yeah? Very good. The classical period is when Mozart, for example, lived, right? Haydn, this guy, was, you know, a very good friend of Mozart. He was a little older. Mozart had a lot of admiration for this gentleman. So did he for Mozart, actually. He really loved himself. This entire era is written in something that we call homophony. And homophony is accompaniment and a melody. Now let's give you a little example from this specific piece that we're about to play of homophony.
Could you demonstrate a little bit of polyphonic string quartet music? Because we've talked about that too, where each line has its own unique character. Nothing is really accompaniment.
That is correct. I'm not sure we have that kind of music with us.
We do have a fugue
coming up, actually.
Oh.
We will be.
We'll show you that when we play.
When we get there, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, okay, perfect.
We'll show you our fugue. Yeah, we have the one. In this piece, oh, and by the way, that fugue is going to be part of a composition by Fanny Mendelssohn, who lived a little bit later in the Romantic period, okay? This piece that we're playing first, as I said, is homophonic, and it has a certain things that need to happen in this piece. This piece is what we call sonata form, and sonata form has certain little pieces to it. The first part is in the name of the key, but then, this is E-flat major, but then the second theme happens in the five. E-flat major has B-flat major as its five. This is what that sounds like. But guess what? When he does it again in this exact same form, cannot come back in the five. It comes back in the same key as he wrote the whole piece. And E flat sounds like this. So he writes the same music, but he writes it in a different key because now we're in the recapitulation, and that is how we use sonata form. Now, the way that the term sonata form came around was from this gentleman, A.B. Marx, Adolf Bernhard Marx, and he came up with this term, and he made the first theme that we showed you as the male theme, and then the second theme that we showed you as the female theme. And when we go to the recapitulation, you see how in the first part, it goes away from the main key, which is E-flat. We did it in E-flat. Then when it comes back in the recapitulation, it comes back in E-flat. Well, this person argues, and again, this is the first person to ever say sonata form in history. He argues that it is the female theme has to submit to the male theme. That's why the key has to change. And so during the latter part of the 19th century, that was the conception of the sonata form, was we had a male theme and a female theme that needed to submit in their relation to that male theme. Later on, we'll be playing a composition by a female composer who lived and grew up in this exact era when these textbooks are being distributed all around the world. And she very much escapes that tradition. You'll hear it in the music. Let's do a little Haydn.
Thank you.
So, you know what? This quartet, you don't like Haydn, huh? This quartet's nicknamed the joke, and we find it hysterical. And so we want to make sure we can play it for you, so we're going to do show you some quick things. This is from the scherzo. The scherzo, word scherzo means joke, actually joke. And Mishkar is hysterically jokestery in this. So can you show them how funny you are?
Okay, this is not normal for the era, but this is what Haydn. See how that's not right? But that is why he wrote for it.
Question.
In this movement, this is where we'll see or hear rondo form?
That's the next movement. Bravo! A plus.
Right. Yeah.
Christian, extra credit.
Well done, bro.
Credit.
Well, we got the rondo coming soon.
Front of the class. Okay. No, all this right. Is the scherzo. Are you ready? And it's hysterical. Here we go.
Thank you.
So we're going to show you. We're going to show you. Here's that. Here you go.
All right. Whoever said rondo, just the word rondo, very nice. This, what we're about to play for you, is called the ritornello. It's another very good word for rondo. It's that part that keeps coming back on the rondo. All right. This is that ritornello. That's the ritornello. See how many times we play the ritornello on this rondo. It'll be A, B, A, C, A, D, A. We'll see how many A's we have. Thank you.